चलो आफ्टर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ फिनॉल्स नेक्स्ट पॉइंट दैट इज फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ अल्कोहल्स एंड फिनॉल्स. ओके फोर प्रॉपर्टीज आर गिवन हियर. फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी दैट इज नेचर ऑफ इंटर मोलिकुलर फोर्सेज. सो विच टाइप ऑफ फोर्स बाइंड दिस टू अल्कोहल मॉलिक्यूल्स टुगेदर और टू फिनॉल मॉलिक्यूल्स टुगेदर. सो इट इज फाउंड दैट OH ग्रुप इन अल्कोहल और फिनॉल इज पोलर. पोलर मीन्स देर इज डिफरेंस इन इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी बिटवीन ऑक्सीजन एंड हाइड्रोजन. ऑक्सीजन बींग मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव गेट्स पार्शियल नेगेटिव चार्ज माइनस डेल्टा एंड हाइड्रोजन एक्वायर्स पार्शियल पॉजिटिव चार्ज. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस negatively charged oxygen of one alcohol ROH attracts positively charged hydrogen of another alcohol molecule. Same is found in ethers. Negatively charged oxygen of one phenol molecule attracts positively charged hydrogen of another phenol molecule. So two alcohol molecules or two phenol molecules are connected to each other through hydrogen. So these two molecules stay together through strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So this dotted line indicates intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So what's the nature of intermolecular forces? Intermolecular hydrogen bonding which bind these at molecules together. Second property is physical state. What is given? Lower alcohols are colorless. They don't have any color. They are toxic liquids. Very important. They are toxic liquids having alcoholic odor. A particular odor that smell is called as alcoholic odor. And phenols are also colorless, toxic. They have lower melting point, low melting solids, and they have carbolic or phenolic odor. Phenol is also known as carbolic acid. So they have said here carbolic odor. Third property, that's the boiling point. We have discussed this in halogen, same point here. As molar mass increases, boiling point increases. Also, with increasing branching, boiling point decreases. Boiling point of alcohol decreases with increasing branching. This is true for isomeric alcohol. See, I have given here one example. N-butyl alcohol, isobutyl alcohol. This is secondary butyl alcohol and this is tertiary butyl alcohol. Boiling points are given here. It boils at 118, 108, 99, and 82. It is found that this is a linear structure, so its boiling point is highest. Here branch is there, but it is primary alcohol. So primary alcohols have higher boiling point than secondary and tertiary corresponding isomeric alcohol. So its boiling point is higher than secondary and tertiary alcohols. Okay. And last property, that is solubility of this alcohols and phenols. So it is found that phenols and lower alcohols up to three carbons means methane, ethane and propane, methanol, ethanol and propanol, they are soluble in water. Why? Again, they form hydrogen bonding with water. Any substance is soluble in water means it forms hydrogen bonding with water or its ionic substance. So water separates these ions. It's a covalent compound, but it forms hydrogen bonding with water. So it is soluble in water. See, this is ROH, alcohol. This is HOH, water. This is another HOH, water. So negative oxygen in each case and positive hydrogen. So plus minus attraction. This water and alcohol are connected through hydrogen. So these phenols and lower alcohols are soluble in water, but with increasing mass this solubility decreases. So these are four physical properties. First one is nature of intermolecular forces, second their physical state, third about their boiling point, and fourth one is solubility of these substances. Now we will move towards chemical properties of these alcohols and phenols. So here they have given three different points, A, B, C, D, like these reactions are given. A point is the lab test, laboratory test. Means in the lab, we have to do some test to identify whether the given substance is alcohol or phenol. So this is a part of your practical also. You will do these reactions in your lab also. So how to identify given substance is alcohol or phenol? So first test to identify that substance is litmus test. Litmus, we know two litmus papers are there, blue litmus and red litmus. What is found? Alcohol is neutral to litmus paper, means blue litmus or red litmus, no litmus change its color in alcohol. So in alcohol, blue litmus remains blue, red litmus remains red. And what happens in presence of phenol? So aqueous solution of phenol turns blue litmus red. Blue becomes red only in acidic medium. So this indicates that phenol is acidic in nature. So this is the first test to identify presence of the substance, to identify nature of the substance, or to identify whether given substance is alcohol or phenol. If there is no change in the color of litmus paper, then that substance is alcohol. And if blue litmus turns red, means that substance is phenol. This is first reaction. Now from the above reaction, it is found that alcohol is neutral and phenol is acidic in nature. If it is acid, then it should react with base. So that is only the second reaction, reaction with base. Whether the substances alcohol and phenol, they react with base or not, that is checked in the lab. How is it? What's the result? Phenol is weakly acidic, so it doesn't react with NaHCO3. NaHCO3 is also weak base. Weak acid and weak base, there is no reaction. Weak acid requires strong base to react. Okay, therefore, but it reacts with NaOH, which is strong base. Phenol is weakly acidic, so it doesn't react with NaHCO3. Remember this point. Phenol and NaHCO3, no reaction. I have mentioned here. Phenol and NaHCO3, there is no reaction. But phenol and NaOH, as compared to NaHCO3, NaOH is strong base. So AROH, that is phenol. Phenol reacts with NaOH. Phenol is acidic. Acid is the substance which gives H plus ion. So this acidic hydrogen is replaced by Na, and H and OH, they form water. So we get ARO minus Na plus. That's the salt formed, which is soluble in water. And if we add HCl in it, again Na and Cl will combine, and H takes the place of Na plus, and we get back that AROH. So it is precipitated. This is your laboratory test. Determine nature of given substance. Under the heading, the given substance is phenol. You have to do this in your practicals in the laboratory. So what's the test? NaOH plus phenol. Given substance, you are not aware that given substance is phenol. So that unknown substance plus NaOH, if you add, then you will find a clear solution. And if in that clear solution you add HCl, then we get a precipitate of that initial substance. If that substance is precipitated out, means initial substance used is phenol. Okay, now this is about phenol, basic nature of phenol. Now alcohol. Alcohol and NaOH and NaHCO3. Alcohol is neutral. We have studied in litmus test. So NaOH and NaHCO3, they do not react with alcohol. No reaction. But as compared to NaOH and NaHCO3, Na metal or potassium metal is stronger base. As compared to NaOH and NaHCO3, Na is stronger base. And that's why it reacts with this alcohol. Strong base can react with strong acid as well as weak acid. So this is weakly acidic. It reacts with Na metal. So what's the change? OH bond breaks and Na takes place of hydrogen, and we get RONa plus H2. RONa, we call this as sodium alkoxide. RONa, sodium alkoxide. In Williamson synthesis, ether preparation, we use this substance, sodium alkoxide. Okay, now basic strength, here I have mentioned that basic strength, it goes on increasing like this. NaHCO3 is weaker than NaOH than Na. Now characteristic test for phenol, means which test gives us confirmation that given substance is phenolic in nature. Okay, this is also included in your syllabus for practicals. What is it? Phenol reacts with neutral FeCl3. Phenol and neutral FeCl3. Take one test tube, add phenol in it, and add neutral FeCl3 in it. So we get dark colored substance. Deep coloration is found. That color is either purple or violet or green, depending upon the structure of this phenol. Different phenols give different color with FeCl3. But out of this three, or somewhat like this shade, is obtained deep colored solution. It's a colorless substance. When it get mixed with FeCl3, we get deep color of ferric phenoxide. So what's the reaction? See, phenol AROH reacts with FeCl3. It is acid, so acid loses hydrogen, so HNCl they combine to form HCl. Valency of Fe is 3 here. Fe forms 3 bonds with 3Cl, so it requires 3 phenoxy groups. So ARO thrice Fe. This is the formula of ferric phenoxide. Ferric phenoxide. This is neutral FeCl3 added in phenol. We get deep colored ferric phenoxide plus HCl. If we get that deep color, means the substance taken initially is phenol. Only phenol shows this reaction. Alcohol and neutral FeCl3, there is no dark color formation. There is no formation of any particular color. This is the distinguishing test between phenol and alcohol. Now, how to distinguish alcohol? So, distinguishing test for alcohol they have given. Already we have discussed this reaction in halogen derivatives. That's the Lucas test. Lucas test. So Lucas reagent is used in this reaction. What is that reagent? That is concentrated HCl and zinc chloride, ZnCl2, anhydrous zinc chloride. We know that when we add alcohol, Lucas reagent in that alcohol solution, then solution becomes turbid due to formation of alkyl halide. So RCH2OH reacts with HCl. It requires anhydrous zinc chloride and heat. Heat is necessary. In halogen derivative, they have not given heat, but heating is must for primary alcohol. And RCH2Cl, OH is replaced by Cl, we get water. Secondary alcohol, RCHOHR, reacts with HCl. Anhydrous zinc chloride is required. No heat means within at room temperature this reaction is carried out, and we get this secondary alkyl halide plus water. And tertiary alcohol reacts with HCl and we get tertiary alkyl halide and water. See the rate of formation of this turbidity in the test tube. The rate, if it is primary alcohol, we get turbidity only after heating. If it is secondary alcohol, slowly we can observe turbid solution. And last one, that is tertiary alcohol, it reacts very fast with Lucas reagent. So instantaneously, very fast, immediate reaction takes place. So instantaneously solution becomes turbid. Here anhydrous zinc chloride is also not required. So this tells us reactivity order of this alcohol towards this reaction is tertiary greater than secondary greater than primary. So this is the distinguishing test for alcohol. Means if we have three test tubes, one containing primary, other containing secondary, and third containing tertiary alcohol, then how to identify which test tube contains which alcohol? So add HCl in each test tube where we find first turbidity, immediate turbidity, so that is tertiary. Then add zinc chloride in other two test tubes. So after some time, if we observe turbidity, means it is secondary alcohol. And if we heat it and then only we find turbidity in the solution, means that substance is primary alcohol. Okay, so these are chemical properties of alcohol which are carried out in lab.